Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject fluid mechanics in machines. This is lecture number 8.2. We are going to solve problems in the turbulent flow. In the earlier lecture, we discussed the theory part of the turbulent flow. Turbulent flow, the Reynolds equation for the turbulent flow, Prandtl's mixing length theory, velocity distribution turbulent flow, friction factor for turbulent flow, and the Modi chart. So these are all the topics we have discussed earlier. And now in this lecture, we are going to solve problems in the turbulent flow from Anna University question papers. Example number 1. Determine the wall shearing stress in a pipe of diameter 100 mm which carries water. The velocities at the pipe center and 30 mm from the pipe center are 2 meters per second and 1.5 meters per second respectively. The flow in the pipe given as turbulent. This is from November 2010 question paper. So we write down the given data. The diameter is 0.1 meter, radius equal to 0.05 meter. The maximum velocity at the center 2 meters per second at radius r equal to 0.03 meter. The velocity is 1.5 meters per second. The distance from the pipe wall, from the given radius, we calculate y equal to outer radius minus radius at which the velocity is measured, 0.05 minus 0.03 equal to 0.02 meter. We calculate the shear velocity. The formula for the shear velocity, u max minus u divided by u star equal to 5.75 logarithmic of r by y. So substituting u max equal to 2, the velocity equal to 1.5 meters per second. Divided by u star is the shear velocity, which is 5.75 logarithmic of 0.05 divided by 0.02. So simplifying, 0.5 divided by u star equal to 2.288. So u star equal to 0.2185 meters per second. Then the wall shear stress, u star equal to square root of tau o divided by rho. Tau o is the wall shear stress, rho is the density of the fluid. So, tau o equal to rho into u star square. So, which is 1000 into 0.2185 square equal to 47.74 newtons per meter square. So, the answer to the problem, wall shear stress equal to 47.74 newtons per meter square. Example number 2. A smooth pipe of diameter 80 mm and 800 meter long carries water at the rate of 0.48 meter cube per minute. Calculate the loss of head, wall shearing stress and center line velocity. Take kinematic viscosity of water as 0.015 stoke. Take the value of coefficient of friction from the relation given as F equal to, friction factor F equal to 0.0791 divided by Reynolds number to the power 0.25, where Re is the Reynolds number. This is from May 2010 question paper. So from the problem we write down the given data, diameter equal to 0.08 meter, radius equal to 0.04 meter, length of the pipe is given as 800 meter, discharge Q equal to 0.48 meter cube per minute, kinematic viscosity nu equal to 0.015 stoke, which is 0.015 10 power minus 4 meter square per second, and the friction factor is given as 0.0791 divided by Reynolds number to the power 0.25. We calculate the area of the pipe, area equal to pi by 4 d square, so 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.08 square equal to 5.024 10 power minus 3 meter square. We calculate the average velocity from the discharge, u equal to q divided by a, discharge divided by a is the average velocity, 0.48 divided by 60, so 0.48 meter cube per minute, to convert into second we divide by 60 divided by area equal to 5.024 10 power minus 3 equal to 1.592 meters per second. Reynolds number Re equal to Ud divided by nu, which is 1.592 into 0.08 divided by 0.015 10 power minus 4 equal to 84,906.7. So the flow is turbulent because the Reynolds number is greater than 2300, the flow is turbulent. Friction factor for turbulent flow, it is the equation is given F equal to 0.0791 divided by Reynolds number to the power 0.25. So, which is 0.0791 divided by 84,906.7 to the power 0.25 equal to 4.63 in 10 power minus 3. Then loss of head due to friction, HF equal to 4FL U square by 2GD. This is the equation. Substituting 4 into 4.63 10 power minus 3 into 800 into 1.59 into square divided by 2 into G is 9.81 and diameter equal to 0.08, which is 23.92 meter. Then wall shear stress tau O equal to F into rho U square by 2. So 4.63 10 power minus 3 into 1000, density is 1000 into 1.59 into square divided by 2 equal to 5.867 newtons per meter square. Central velocity U max at R equal to Y equal to R, capital R. So we have to calculate the shear velocity. U star equal to square root of tau O by rho, which is square root of 5.867 divided by 1000 equal to 0.0766 meters per second. And we have the expression to calculate the maximum velocity, U max by U star equal to 5.75 logarithmic of 10 into U star into R divided by nu plus 5.55. So substituting numerical values, U max is the unknown, the maximum velocity, that is centerline velocity is unknown, divided by 0.0766 equal to 5.75 into logarithmic of base 10 into U star 0.0766 into 0.04 divided by 0.015 10 power minus 4 plus 5.55 equal to right hand side value is 24.58. So U maximum equal to 24.58 into 0.0766 equal to 1.88 meters per second. The answer to the problem, the loss of head is 23.92 meter, wall shear stress equal to 5.867 newtons per meter square, centering velocity is 1.88 meters per second. Example number 3, a smooth pipe of diameter 80 mm and 900 meter long carries water at the rate of 0.5 meter cube per minute. Calculate loss of head due to the friction, wall shearing stress, centering velocity, velocity and shear stress at 30 mm from the pipe wall. Also calculate the thickness of the laminar sublayer. Take the kinematic viscosity of water as 0.015 Stoke. The value of friction coefficient is calculated by the relation F equal to 0.0791 divided by Reynolds number to the power 0.25, where Re is the Reynolds number. So we write down the given data. Diameter is 0.08 meter, length equal to 900 meter, discharge Q equal to 0.5 meter cube per minute, kinematic viscosity nu equal to 0.015 Stoke, which is 0.015 10 power minus 4 meter square per second, and the friction factor is given as 0.0791 divided by Reynolds number to the power 0.25. We calculate the area of the pipe. Area equal to pi by 4 d square, 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.08 square equal to 5.024 10 power minus 3 meter square. We calculate the average velocity from the discharge, u equal to q divided by a, which is 0.5 divided by 60. So the 60 is introduced to convert minute into second. So 0.5 divided by 60 in meter cube per second into 5.024 in 10 power minus 3 equal to 1.66 meters per second. Then Reynolds number Re equal to UD divided by nu, which is 1.66 into 0.08 divided by 0.015 in 10 power minus 4 equal to 88,533. Again the flow is turbulent because the Reynolds number is greater than 2300 for internal flow. Then friction factor is given as F equal to 0.0791 divided by Reynolds number to the power 0.25, which is 0.0791 divided by 88,533 to the power 0.25 equal to 4.58 10 power minus 3. The loss of head due to friction, HF equal to 4FL U square divided by 2GD. So 4 into 4.58 in 10 power minus 3 into 900 into 1.60 square divided by 2 into 9.81 into diameter 0.08, which is 28.94 meter. The wall shearing stress, tau O equal to F into rho U square divided by 2. So 4.58 in 10 power minus 3 into density is 1000, velocity is 1.60 square divided by 2, which is 6.31 newtons per meter square. Then centerline velocity U maximum at Y equal to R, that is R at the center of the pipe. So we calculate the shear velocity U star equal to square root of tau O by rho, which is square root of 6.31 divided by 1000 equal to 0.0794 meters per second. Then we have the, we use the same expression to calculate the maximum velocity, U max by U star equal to 5.75 log 10 into U star into R divided by nu plus 5.55. Substituting numerical values, U max divided by 0.0794 equal to 5.75 log 10 into log 10 of 0.0794 into 0.04 divided by 0.015 10 power minus 4 plus 5.55. Right hand side value is 24.67. So U maximum equal to 24.67 into 0.0794 equal to 1.96 meters per second. Velocity and shear stress at 30 millimeter from the wall. So y equal to 0.03 meter. So small r equal to capital R minus y, which is 0.04 minus 0.03 equal to 0.01 meter. Then u by u star. Now the expression is modified. U by u star equal to 5.75 into logarithmic of base 10 of u star y divided by nu plus 5.55. Once again, substitute the numerical values. U divided by 0.0794 equal to 5.75 into logarithmic of base 10 of 0.0794 into 0.03 divided by 0.015 into 10 power minus 4 plus 5.55 equal to 23.95. So U equal to 23.95 into 0.0794 equal to 1.9 meters per second. Then the shear stress at the given radius, tau equal to tau O, wall shear stress into small r by capital R, which is 6.31 into 0.01 divided by 0.04 equal to 1.5775 newtons per meter square. Thickness of the laminar sublayer, delta dash equal to 16 into nu divided by u star. So 16 into 0.015 10 power minus 4 divided by 0.0794 equal to 0.302 in 10 power minus 3 meter, which is 0.302 millimeter. The answer to the problem, loss of head due to friction 28.94 meter, wall shear stress 6.31 newtons per meter square, centering velocity 1.96 meters per second, velocity and shear stress at 30 millimeter from the wall 1.9 meters per second and 1.5775 newtons per meter square, and thickness of the laminar sublayer is 0.302 millimeter. Example number 4. Water is flowing through a rough pipe of diameter 50 centimeter and length 5000 meter at the rate of 0.48 meter cube per second. Find the power required to maintain the flow. Take the average height of the roughness as K equal to 0.4 millimeter. So diameter of the pipe 0.5 meter, length equal to 5000 meter, discharge Q equal to 0.48 meter cube per second. The friction factor, roughness factor K equal to 0.4 millimeter, which is 0.4 into 10 power minus 3 meter. So we calculate the area of the pipe, area equal to pi by 4 d square, which is 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.5 square, which is equal to 0.19625 meter square. Area, average velocity U equal to discharge divided by area, so 0.48 divided by 0.19625 equal to 2.44 meters per second. Then the friction factor for rough pipe, it is given by 1 by square root of 4F equal to 2 into logarithmic of base 10 of R by K plus 1.74. Substitute numerical values, 1 by square root of 4F equal to 2 into logarithmic of base 10 of 0.25 divided by 0.4 into 10 power minus 3 plus 1.74 equal to 7.33. So calculating F from this equation, F friction factor F equal to 4.65 10 power minus 3. Then loss of head due to friction, HF equal to 4FL U square divided by 2GD. So 4 into 4.65 10 power minus 3 into 5000 into 2.44 square divided by 2 into 9.81 into 0.5 equal to 56.44 meter. The power required to maintain the flow, P equal to rho GQ into HF. So 1000 into 9.81 into 0.48 into 56.44 equal to 265.76 kilowatts. So the power required to maintain the flow in the rough pipe is 265.76 kilowatts. The answer to the problem. Example number 5. A rough pipe of diameter 50 centimeter and length 1000 meter carries water at the rate of 0.45 meter cube per second. The wall roughness is 0.012 millimeter. Determine coefficient of friction, wall shear stress, centering velocity, and velocity at a distance 150 millimeter from the pipe wall. So we are given diameter equal to 0.5 meter, length equal to 1000 meter, discharge equal to 0.45 meter cube per second. The roughness factor K equal to 0.012 millimeter, which is 0.012 in 10 power minus 3 meter. we calculate the area of the pipe. Area equal to pi by 4 d square, 3.14 divided by 4 into 0.5 square equal to 0.19625 meter square. And average velocity we calculate u equal to q divided by a. So 0.45 divided by 0.19625 equal to 2.29 meters per second. Then friction factor, once again we use the same expression for rough pipe, 1 by square root of 4f equal to 2 logarithmic of 10 r by k plus 1.74. Substitute numerical values, 1 by square root of 4f equal to 2 into logarithmic of 10 of 0.25 divided by 0.012 in 10 power minus 3 plus 1.74 equal to 10.37. Now calculating f from this expression, f equal to 2.32 in 10 power minus 3. Friction factor F equal to 2.32 in 10 power minus 3. Then wall shear stress, tau O equal to F into rho U square by 2. So 2.32 in 10 power minus 3 into 1000 into 2.29 square divided by 2 equal to 6.081 newtons per meter square. Then central line velocity at the Y equal to R. So to calculate the central line velocity, we record the shear velocity U star. U star equal to square root of tau O divided by rho, which is square root of 6.08 divided by 1000 equal to 0.078 meters per second. Then using this expression, u max by u star equal to 5.75 log 10 r by k plus 8.5. u max by 0.078 equal to 5.75 into logarithmic of 10 of 0.25 divided by 0.012 in 10 power minus 3 plus 8.5 equal to 33.33. Right hand side value is equal to 33.33. So the maximum velocity u max equal to 33.33 into 0.078, which is 2.6 meters per second. Now the velocity at 150 millimeter from the pipe wall, y equal to 0.15 meter. We take the same expression, modified for the new distance, u by u star equal to 5.75 log 10 of y by k plus 8.5. So substituting u by 0.078 equal to 5.75 into log 10 of 0.15 divided by 0.012 in 10 power minus 3. Plus 8.5 equal to 32.06. Now u, velocity at 150 millimeter from the pipe wall, u equal to 32.06 into 0.078 equal to 2.5 meters per second. The answer to the problem, the coefficient of friction 2.3 to 10 power minus 3, wall shear stress 6.08 newtons per meter square, center line velocity 2.6 meters per second, and the velocity at distance 150 millimeter from the pipe wall equal to 2.5 meters per second. We stop here. So these are all the books I published in mechanical engineering, and you have fluid mechanics and machinery book. So you may refer to the book for more problem on the in the subject, particularly in the turbulent flow. And all the I upload the video lectures of the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. So thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again another video lecture on the fluid mechanics and machines. Until then, bye bye.